Hi, I'm Sharon.
And I'm Gerard.
And this video is all about
electric motors. Did you see that?
It went by so fast.
Electric motors are one of the many devices that can power a robot. It can power something as big as a car and fit into something as small as a toy.
But all motors have two things in common, magnets and electricity.
All the robots at Sparky's Robot World zip across the field, powered by electric motors that look like this.
In this design, each motor drives a pair of wheels on one side of the frame. We also use motors to power the shooter on top of the robot.
But what makes motors spin? Where does the power come from? Well, to answer this question, we have to go to our engineers at Sparky's Robot Lab.
As you can see, when I place these two magnets together with opposite poles together, they attract and they stick together. And you can see this attraction is pretty strong. It takes a lot of force for it to fall off. But when I place two of the same poles together, S and S, they repel, they push each other apart. You can see this on the table when I push it together and it spins around.
When the electric motor does, it supplies that magnetic principle and forces the magnets in a circle. So when I put the north side to the north end, it pushes the entire apparatus around in a circle. You can also make a temporary magnet by using electricity and a coiled wire. The coil can't pick up the paper clips right now because there's no electricity running through it.
However, if I plug these alligator clips into the opposite ends of the wire, like so, and then I take these two and I plug them into an electrical source down here, I'll increase the strength of the electricity, and you can see that the paper clips are picked up by the coil magnet very easily. And then if I decrease the strength, they fall off.
When you combine these two concepts, you get something like this.
When I take these two alligator clips and I attach them to the two ends of this wire, and then I increase the strength of the electricity source down here, give it a little spin, there we go. As you can see, it started to spin, and when I decreased the electricity, it stopped spinning.
Now, the way this works is the electricity flows through the opposite ends of the wire and makes a magnetic field around the coil, just like you saw in the last experiment. Now, this magnetic field interacts with the magnet at the top of the motor. It is attracted first and then repelled by the other end of the magnet, and that's what causes it to spin in a continuous circle.
This model right here is the basic inside workings of an electric motor.
So here we have an actual motor. Inside you can see all the coils just like we showed you in the previous experiment, and on the inside of this is a magnet that is used just like the magnet on this motor.
This is an exact replica of this open motor here. When I take the alligator clips and I plug them into the opposite ends of this wire, like so, and then I increase the strength of this electricity, the electric motor starts to spin. And there goes the daisy, isn't that nice? Right now I have it on full power, so it's spinning at full power, but when I decrease the strength of the electricity, the electric motor, of course, slows down.
Awesome, so now I have a spinning motor. So what can I do with it?
Well, to answer this question, we brought in Tito, a robot builder from Wissahickon High School in Ambler, Pennsylvania.
And I brought along Miss Daisy, a robot that uses multiple electric motors to pick up the ball from the ground and throw it into the air. The whole system starts with this electric motor here in the front left corner of the robot. It rotates these aluminum tubes, which moves these rubber belts to pick up the ball from the ground and move it into the belly of the robot. Once in the belly of the robot, another electric motor, located here behind the tower, moves these rubber belts to move the ball into the tower of the robot. Once in the robot's tower, two more electric motors work together to spin up this shooter wheel to throw the ball into the air.
Wow, that's so cool. Thanks for stopping by.
Thanks for having me.
Well, that was a little on electric motors. Please watch some of our other videos and visit Sparky's Bot Lot to drive a robot of your own.
Thanks for visiting!